In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create this animation in 7 minutes. We'll also learn how to create a gradient emission material that goes from green to red. Let's create a curved spiral torus. If you don't see that, please activate an add-on called Extra Objects. I'll add random values to create a random spiral. That looks good. Let's bevel the curve and add a gradient emission material. We need to use a special node setup to have this green to blue and to red emission gradient material. Here are the full nodes. The idea is to use the texture coordinates generate and gradient texture node to make that possible. When we use a set of nodes like this, then we'll have a smooth gradient emission material. Let's make a 100 frames long animation. On the first frame, I'll hover the cursor on the rotation, Z, and type, I, as in India to set a new keyframe. On the last frame, I'll hover the cursor over the same spot, change the value to 359, and type, I, to set a new keyframe. In Animation tab, go to Channel, Extrapolation Mode, and select Linear Extrapolation Mode. Let's duplicate the mesh, rotate it, and reverse the animation like this. If we play the animation at this state, the duplicated mesh will move upward. Right-clicking the frame region at the bottom, and deleting the keyframes will remove all keyframes. The keyframes were successfully removed from the duplicated mesh. Let's rotate the new mesh a bit more, and reset all transforms. Control A to reset all transforms, so that the duplicated mesh won't move away. Now we can set reversed animation frames. 0 for the first frame, and minus 359 for the last frame. We can duplicate, scale, and move more meshes. Let's remove all animation frames by right-clicking the bottom animation frames regions, and deleting the keyframes. Please select each mesh to rotate, scale, or move them to make them look good for the final animation render. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.